Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Mind Z. Today is a very special day. Today we release the 100 subscriber special. Ooh, yeah. Okay, so it has been a long time. I think it's been 2 years, but it's been about 6 months that I started uploading regularly. But yeah, so thank you guys for everything up to now. I mean, we've gone through a lot of highs and lows, and I know it's only 100 subs, but to me that's a pretty big deal. So I decided to put together this lore and more video that you're currently watching. In this video, you will see the standard lore blocks. You're going to see the Simoon's songs. You're going to see all the where the secret sounds are. And you're going to see a whole bunch of cool places that are a part of Mind Z that I hope you guys kind of enjoy. I know a lot of my friends didn't know about what's in this video. And so yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Thank you again for 100 subs. Thank you to everybody on the Reddit page who has supported me throughout all this. And finally, I'd like to thank anybody who has played along with me and who has helped me film all my videos. So guys, here we go. Alright guys, so here we are at our first lore block. And we are actually at Grimdale with the coordinates of negative 1778 and 367. So here it reads. Right click. Once former capital of the human race served as the main resistance against the gods. Oh my goodness, this is a long lore. Okay, humans, tired with being used as pawns in the war of god against god, they rallied together here. With iron and steel, the humans forged weaponry to defend themselves with. After the plague spread across the land, the Thieves Guild fled from their home to the Lost Castle to resume business below the now busy streets of Grimdale. Alright, on to the next lore block. So here we are, guys. We are at Castle Bysfer of the coordinates, as you see on my left. And we are going to get the first Bysfer lore, and let's read it out. Alright, we'll just wait for that to pop up. It says, after Hestral's torment was transferred to the land, mortality was stricken from people. It was here at Bysfer Castle where the races worked, advancing science in an attempt to cure the undead. With magic no longer available, it was at a lost cause. It was a lost cause, and the laboratory below was eventually overrun. So guys, the next couple lores that we're going to do are down in the dungeon, and let's go to those. Alright, so here's a clip from my Bysfer video, but I still got the lore. It says, it doesn't take a hero to order men into battle, it takes a hero to be one of those men who goes into battle. And the last one in Bysfer is to the left here. We're just going to follow MLG, and we go take another left. Okay, to the right is a zombie spawner, as he's pointing there. But it says, subject Z87 was captured and contained by Bysfer scientists. This creature devours anything in its path, from zombies to animals to even people. They attempted to tame this creature so it could be used as a guardian for Bysfer. They were unsuccessful. There it is. Okay, so we're back with another piece of lore. Obviously, we're at the Statue of Agni, and let us right-click. It says, before you is the physical form of Agni, god slash goddess of fire. Agni switches between genders at will when communicating with the races of this land. His slash her temper is unmatched and is well known for their wrath. After being sealed, Agni now remains frozen in the stasis, awakening to walk the land once more. That would be a cool power, change genders. Go for that.
Yep.
On to the next lore.
Okay. Not doing that one yet. Mm-mm. Okay, so
just
We'll go first.
You're always going to go first, because this iron gear doesn't get itself.
Okay. Oh, yep. Okay. Let's walk one block forward.
Nice.
This is the lower block.
Welcome to Davy Jones' locker, and then you're teleported up.
Welcome to Davy Jones' locker.
That's a good voice. I like that one.
Me too.
Jeebus grapes, please no.
Now, moment of truth, if this is still here. Wish me luck. Yep. Oh, be careful. I landed on a tree branch. Make sure you're on full health or where your feather fallings. Because I almost died because there's a tree branch.
So just jump straight down.
Yeah, but you'll land on the tree branch and take some fall damage.
Okay, wait. If I just walk right off this boat... You know what, screw it.
Yeah, it's big.
Ha!
Yeah. So, yeah, I actually take credit for discovering this because I failed that jump when trying to
do this dungeon as a video.
And I'm really proud of myself for discovering this. So it's a water source. It's safe. I can heal you.
Yeah, if you wanted to, you could probably jump one block to the left or the right.
Yeah,
which wouldn't be a bad idea.
But I don't think this has ever been shown on YouTube or Reddit before. So,
well, here's a
we are pioneers, and this is the enchanting table. It says, "Welcome
to our welcome to JV Jones Oasis."
And then you're back at the start of the dungeon.
Are we gonna do it again?
Well, there's one more lore.
Okay, chill.
Aren't there epic chests here?
Yeah. Just hit that button.
That's so cool. I think I only learned about this last time. Door closes in how many minutes?
5, 10 or something.
Ooh, perfect.
You can have it all.
Pants and an enchanted bow. Bam. This makes a bridge for you to travel to the next part of the dungeon, if you can't tell. Okay. Hurry.
Alright, so we're at Tristidia. And we're gonna go to the dangerous lore block.
Yep.
So we have to go to the left room and then put some items. So have some items handy.
Let's do this. Okay, so left room you put in the items?
Let's go. The bunker's right here.
Yeah, but you said you put items in the left room.
Yeah. Let's go.
There you go. Okay, I'm going to the left room. I put in a bunch of items. Oh, it's here. Go. Oh, nice. Oh, that's the Ghostcraft ghost.
Alright, so welcome to Tristidia, the hidden home of forbidden arts. It is here that the deep jungle of Tristidia, a new species, was born. Those who witnessed its creation only knew about it. The necromancer... Oh, I'm going to read that when we get out. Can we please get out?
Right, zombie.
I'm bleeding.
Okay, I'll heal you when we get out.
Let's go.
Pegasus. There's a Pegasus.
Oh!
Splash. Run, fridge.
Do you not like see when I die?
That you died.
All right, so I'm gonna finish reading that. You died too.
Yeah. Okay.
So it says, "Welcome to."
Welcome to Tristitia, the home of forbidden arts. It is here in the deep jungle of Tristitia a new species was born. Those who witnessed its creation only know it in the necromancer tongue as ghost.
Much like a chameleon,
the ghost blended when it's...
I can't read because the P in your name was in the way. Hold on. I need to move my head away from you. You disgust me. Okay.
Only know the necromancer tongue or ghost. Much like chameleon, the ghost blended with its environment, becoming unseen to the naked eye. Quickly grew out of control, scaling the trees, murdering everyone involved.
Vicious
stabs from behind and a fearsome scream that echoed through the night. All records of its existence and the ritual used to create it were destroyed. The ghost was never seen again. So that's Ghostcraft, right?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Alright, I guess we're on to the next lore then. Alright, so guys, we're here at Floating Islands at the very top. And we're just gonna run in, grab some crap. Go.
I need a hat.
I'll read that once I'm up, because this is... super fun.
Is this super fun? Are you not having... Oh, I didn't click it. Okay, lore block at the air spire, or earth spire.
Alright, I will read it out. Wow, I got some really good respiration helmets.
If you don't do a voice, I'm rereading it out.
Alright. The spire of Therum is the sealing stone of this goddess of earth, Therum. This spire has experienced significant damage on the protective layer, weakening the hold on the gods. The spire is rather fitting to represent Therum, a slow-moving but extremely deadly hunk of earth wavering through the floating islands.
That was awesome.
That was my best voice, I'm sorry.
That was a good voice.
On to the next lore. Alright, so here's one of the other lore blocks way down in there. So we're just at the water spire here of the coordinates, as you see on my screen. And we are going to just jump down and hit this thing.
Got it.
Left, right, there we go. So the Pluvia Spire is one of the ceiling gods of himself. Okay, hold on. The Spire of Pluvia.
Hang on, I'll read it, because I have a really good reading voice, as people some say.
As people some say. Okay, go ahead, read it.
Alright, I have a really good voice. The Spire of Pluvia is one of the ceiling stones of the god of water. Pluvia kept to himself, deep below the ocean, too involved in his own knowledge and wisdom to care about the matters of this world. Much like the prayers of the citizens of Al-Hasa to water for their crops. This spire is a monument frigid as Pulvia himself drowning in his own thoughts.
That says frigid. That's almost fridge. That's a point for the fridge. All right. Yeah. On to the next lore block.
Okay.
All right. So as you can see, guys, we made it up to the spire. And let's see if I can just get this lore. Okay. Okay, the Spire of Agni is one of the sealing stones of the god slash goddess fire of the fire Agni. After the gods were sealed, these spires served as seals, forever trapping the gods in a different dimension. Mages of all beliefs worked tirelessly, crafting each spire, as one would simply not be enough to contain the powerful gods. They stand as grim reminders of the danger lurking from the past. Unfortunately, after the gods were sealed, magic dissipated from this dimension. Where am I? These magical structures cannot be repaired without the tools that created them, and are all that holds the gods from returning to this land. Alright, some good chunk of lore. Let's not die. But before we go, I want to take a look at the individual signs that you can find here. Yes. So I don't know what order they are in, but it says the sun and the moon have always been in conflict. Their fight has raged for centuries, never ending. There's potato. Fancy. The sun began the light, the moon brought darkness. Neither could agree on which was better. I told you there was a trap. I told you. Damn it. All right. The night brought danger, always killing them. The sun retaliated, letting the use of the four. The fight never ends. The world forcing it into balance. The balance must exist. Without it, nothing. And more slowness. Some chain. Bippity boppity boop. And I think that's it. So we are here at Ravine for one of the lores. This will be our second last one, because unfortunately, in a recent update, they actually took out the lore, which makes me cry. It used to be right there, but it's not there anymore. Alright, so we see that button. We're going to shoot that button. Masha's got the worst aim I've ever seen.
Bouncing.
Oh, I hit it.
There we go. See? And it all just appears.
Oh. Magic. And that's how you're supposed to get down to the thingy. Let's go down and let's just explore this.
Is it... Yeah, it's disappeared.
Yep.
I don't think you can get back, though. Oh, yeah, there's a ladder here.
Plus, we have grappling abilities, so it's not that big a deal.
There's still a sign there.
Oh, there is, like, an actual thing. Yeah, there is a sign, so let's see what it says. It says, I hope you brought a bow, aim true, and make haste. Okay, so let's... I want to see if I can make it. But I don't. So.
Well, you can get back through that ladder. You got tons of time.
Should I go across? Alright.
Yeah, if you want. Watch out for that zombie.
There's a player down there. So I was gonna go farm pots at Ravine. But I don't wanna. Maybe it was this one. Was it over here?
What?
The lore?
It was on both of them.
There was a lore on both?
Yeah, because it was in two parts.
Oh, Jesus, I thought I died. Alright, so that will conclude this lore, because this lore unfortunately wasn't there, but I will read the text for you and put it on screen, and yeah. So it used to be that when you hit the block, it says, so you seek the truth? Come visit my sacred grounds. But make haste, as the path will soon disappear. Look in front of you and see what the truth holds. And then after those blocks would disappear, it would actually say, I will be waiting. And once you get down to where the potions are, there's a cauldron. And you will just say, goodbye, human, dot, dot, dot. Thanks, MLG, for the clips. All right, guys, we are here at the Earth Spire. And I'm going to go down this
Wind
way.
Spire.
Whatever. The Spire. Underground Spire will be vague today, because it's back here. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's beyond this jungle.
And there's nothing here other than this lore block. So I hope they fix that. Maybe they'll put some chests here, because literally it's the most useless of the four spires. Anyway. Oh, it's Simoon. Damn it, it is wind. Okay, you win.
Yeah,
okay, so it's inverted. So the one on Floating Islands is the other one. We'll wait for all this to load. Okay, so it says, the Spire of Simoon is long abandoned and forgotten, much like the former Great Air Temple Animo Sanctum. Earthquakes over the years have begun to rip the spire to pieces, weakening the hold on the gods. The spire carries the decoration of the symbol of air representing Simoon, the god of wind, known for being a trickster among the gods and the races of this world. So there you go.
If you come over here...
Oh, like, do we? Oh, yeah.
South.
Yeah, coming. I'm not that bad with directions. Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's the same symbol we saw in Animos.
Yeah.
The cool-looking S that's also in Smash, is it not? No? Maybe?
No, I don't think so.
Anyway, it's cracked. It looks like it's fallen over from over there or something. But it's an S. Looks pretty cool. And, yeah. So, I think I'm going to end my lore aspect to this here. But if you guys want to stick around, we have a bunch of cool things about MindZ that maybe you didn't know. And a couple of hidden secrets that me and Mosh are going to go and review. And kind of just check out. Maybe not Mosh, but, you know, whatever. Whatever he comes with, whatever he doesn't. I'll do it with a bunch of people, and we'll find a whole bunch of really cool things hidden across the map that I hope you guys enjoy. So, on to that. Okay. Hey guys, we are back. This is actually going to be a continuation of the lores, and we, me and Rezo, or Rezo and I, are going to continue by doing sort of bonus lores. So we're going to run into Agni Ignis here. Seems like
okay.
A great
Don't
idea.
Step on the pressure plate, we'll do that after we go over the signs upstairs.
Yep.
Because
remember, we're going to slash
cool.
Hub if anything bad happens. Alright, so, watch the door for me.
Mm-hmm.
It says, Day 3, if you are reading this, it means my defenses didn't stand a chance. The virus is spreading. Day 10, Agni Ignis has been overwhelmed. Day 16, oh crap, I can't read that. It is quiet here. Only the moans of the dead. Day 25. Supplies have run out. Blood should suffice. Day 30. The meat is quite tasty. So I guess that means that...
this guy's slowly turning into a zombie. Not
yeah.
Not driving him insane. Happy things.
Alright, so we're gonna... Piston... Where? Over there.
Yep.
Cool.
Button number 3.
Button number 3 opens this.
Yeah. This is always what confused me. Okay, so look.
Cool.
This befuddled me last time. So you
just
put
chill,
one there.
Just chill. Yeah, there's
I
two.
I put one here, and two. Then this thing opens, but it doesn't actually do anything.
And then you get open. I don't know, it opens up in secret basement. Because there's no actual way out of here. So I guess this is supposed to represent the safety bunker that they used in Agni Ignis. And there's the middle, which we will go explore in a sec, because I heard there's some really tasty signs.
Okay, I'm running south to the first sign.
Okay. Earth granted stability.
Earth brought sickness.
Alright, to the left. Quick! Water granted life, water brought death. Next! Air granted freedom, air brought instability. Next! Fire granted power, fire brought destruction. I'm leaving. We can talk about this.
The thing about this place is the big rainbow wool that's like power kind of combining and stuff.
You could actually.
Cool. No one really looks at it.
I just want to go up here. It's safe up here. Is there pigment spawners?
There's nothing up here. No chest, no pickaxe.
Perfect. Alright, this is a great spot to chill then. So yeah, you can see that really cool looking middle there. That looks like an eagle or something. Alright, and one of the other cool signs in one of the buildings says, if you're reading this, that means you must have survived. I have left you something in a secret place. If you wish to go retrieve it, go to the head. So we looked all across the heads and we couldn't find anything. So I guess it's a mystery, but it might be referring to Simon's song. We are here, guys. We are at Ravine to show you how to get one of the many secret sounds. So this is the first... Is it the first one?
Yes, the first one.
All right. So that would not have made sense if we had already found one before this. But anyway, the secret sounds, we can start working our way down, are located all across the map, and they lead you to a place, which most of you may know how to get to already, called Simon's Song. So these are called secret sounds, because like it's a song, so you make a bunch of sounds, and lo and behold, we're magic. Anyway, so these sounds... Nobody knows how to find all of them, except for Mosh and I right now. And after this video, you will too. So, when we're here at Ravine, we just place a button on this door.
Boop.
And I'm assuming there's a way in, or a way out, yeah. So it says secret sound number one. And all of these sounds, except for the last two, will give us a coordinate. So here we get our first X coordinate. And it's the number 3, so that means something is located at 3, and then XXX, and then negative XXXX. Yeah, that was 4. Alright, so I guess we are going to go on to the next sound.
Yeah.
Alright guys, we are back with our second secret sound. I forgot what I was going to say there. And we're joined by Mosh again, so let's go down. And we're at the forest, by the way, and there's the forest ravine. I haven't been here since they added this thing. That's how long ago it's been. But anyway, we're gonna wander down and keep wandering. Probably should have started filming later, but it's okay. Oh, is that how you get out? I got lost in here when I came here. I kind of just fell down. Okay, and we work our way over here. We're around. I don't know where I'm going, but I trust in Mosh. There's a zombie. We're gonna keep walking. And walking. And there it is. Death. So secret sound number 2 of 10. And you get the second X coordinate and number 4. So there we go. And it's on to secret sound number 3.
Yeah.
So here is secret sound number 3. And you get XX8X negative XXXX. And so we still don't know anything about the Z, but this is at Basil in the southeastern house. Just behind the, just behind this little counter here where a chest spawns. And let's take a look at the sign. So there you go. And so that's about it for number 3. And we're on to number 4. Alright, so guys, we've made it to secret sound 4 out of 10. And as you can see, we get a fourth coordinate on the first X. And yeah. Why? Oh. I don't need those. Anyway, we'll see you at the next sign. Alright, so here we are, next to a whole bunch of zombie spawners. But there is the secret sound number 5. Alright, and we get the first of the Z coordinates, number 5 out of 10. Alright, on to the next secret sound. I'm really scared. Alright guys, we are back with one of the 6 secret sound? Yeah, there it is. Okay, so we're at the 6th secret sound, and you saw my coordinates there. We are in Frostbane, right in front of the church, on the super cool windmill. And it took me a while to find this. People are like, oh, it's on the windmill. It is right there. And like, that would have taken me forever. So we get a second Z coordinate. We get the number 4. And that's 6 out of 10. So I guess we are on to the next one. Okay, so guys, we found the least known of the signs. And where is it?
Right there.
There it is. Secret sound 7 of 10, and we get our third coordinate. So thanks to Mosh, we kind of brainstormed a little bit, and we made it, and we're at Coal Castle. So one of the very unique locations of Mine Z, there are my coordinates. And we actually found the sign just kind of lying around. But I'll show you the last three of them, and we'll see you at the next sign.
See ya.
Okay, so we are here. Is it here?
No.
No.
Follow me.
Follow
me. Around here.
Oh, very tricky. I would have never found that. All right, so here we are, guys, at the last secret sound that has the coordinates on it. And we are in a fire. Here are the coordinates. So you can see it, 270, 18, 69, and negative 575. And here is secret sound number 8. And we actually get the last of our Z coordinates for the secret dungeon. All right, so we made it to number 9. We are at the observatory. And it's a secret sound. Number 9 out of 10, the button must face east. Alright, on to the next sign. Alright, so here we are at the very last secret sound. We actually found them all, which was surprising. But there are the coordinates again. And so we get secret sound number 10 out of 10, saying the button must be south of the rose. So as you guys may know, this leads to the Simon Sound Song Dungeon. And, yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed finding all those with me, and we're gonna move on to the next kind of bonus, secret thing in Mind-Z. Alright, so guys, at the Bisford Labs, in this really cool dungeon, we have a few things that are really cool. There's these little documents that kind of describe what went on here, and, so I got Mind Reapers and Saints to show me what is going down.
Alright, this way.
This way.
This way, Mr. Guy.
Mr. Guy is on his way. To the right, right? Right.
Up here.
This one?
Yeah, there's one in each of these doors.
Alright, so let's go like that. Two sugars. Don't mind if I do. And document.
Document. Their way out.
Alright, so I'm going to actually just put a freeze frame here. Document Z-87-C. Subject Z-87. Vaccine A-12 was administered to subject Z-87 and was under close observation. Subject entered an enraged state and attempted to break containment. This continued for 3 hours before subject fell over unconscious. Dr. Phillips has forbidden any further testing with A-12. These vaccines are not helping improving his behavior. We need to start from scratch. Okay, next one.
Alright, so then you have to get out, you have to press this button down there. And then you just walk. And eventually, the door opens.
Is everyone ready? I'm going to use my button on this one.
Wait for fridge.
Alright, so in this house here, we have another document. And... okay, so this is where it talks about milk, and I'm going to read this out. And freeze frame. Milk has proven to be a cure for the infection when given to a human who hasn't turned. The dead have shown no signs of regaining human traits when given vaccines with milk. Our research has failed to provide any information on why it works on the living. More testing is needed. Okay, perfect. Let's go.
You're holding your block, by the way. Fridge, you're holding your block.
I'm holding my block. What does my block mean?
Switch your sword. Switch out of your sword. There you go.
Why? What was wrong with that?
You would have glitched
your,
back.
Yours.
Yeah.
All right.
Damn it. How do you get through what I don't?
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh!
I died.
Shit! I don't know what to do. Oh, this.
Hey, Gary, you got all those. I've had it.
Baby pigment.
I blew him up. I'm stuck in a cobweb though.
All right.
Okay, so now fridge. Put the button on the iron door.
Here.
And there's a lore block.
This one?
I think so. Yeah.
I don't know how long these doors will hold. Those things are bound to break it down at any moment. I'm writing this in hopes someone will find it. Something must have went horribly wrong. Some kind of zombified pigs walking on two legs have infested our facility. I have no idea where they came from or how they got to this island. I need to...
So, does anyone know how to...
How do I get out?
Here, I can let you out. If worse is worse.
Okay. Move out of the way. Yeah.
I'm just recording.
A new vaccine is ready for testing. Unfortunately, castle numbers have become thin. We need to locate a new animal type for testing. Baxter is in search of pigs. Testing the new vaccine should be ready in the coming weeks if all goes as planned.
Did you get this one, Bridge?
I haven't shot research anything.
Okay, research.
Oh, I see it
on the dock. Oh! Wait, what?
You take this button, okay? You have a bow? Yeah, you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you're holding.
We've learned a great deal from this mysterious portal. Our excavation team brought back a considerable amount of unknown white stone found within the hot surface and along the cliff sides. Mining and extracting these new materials has proven quite difficult given the unusual terrain that the dimension has created. Even so, there is so much we can learn from this dimension and so much we can do with these new items. Creating and combining. The rest of the document is torn off. Alright, so for this one, guys, it was really intense trying to get these ones, so I didn't exactly... I got the sign here, you're going to see in a second, but this is the hardest room of the dungeon if you're doing it. So there's the document, and I'm going to read it in a second, but I didn't scroll up, so I'm just going to read what they have on the wiki. Torn document regarding P-47, subject P-47, one day after initial vaccination of T-92. Subject signs of notable anxiety to its surroundings. 2 days after initial vaccination of T-92. Subject shows loss of pigment in head and lower region. And then back in the Minecraft chat, we see 4 days after initial vaccination of T-92, subject shows increased hostility and attempts to break down his cell door. The rest of the document is torn off. And then this document here just has the bottom half of a page, and I'll read it out for you. Has been destroyed. We must continue to develop the medicines regardless of our losses, lest this breakout become an apocalypse. So this was found during the same run and is found courtesy of Noka in the undead containment room. Dear Emily, I fear the lack of security personnel on this project will be our undoing. What will be our plan if and when shit hits the fan? How will we respond, secure and protect everyone that's working down here? My only hope is that things will stay quiet and research will continue uninterrupted. Love, James. So the next one in the Biosphere Labs, and these are just in any order, guys, I'm sorry about that, but is in experimentation room number one. On the right, you have this head here, and there's a document right next to him. While doing an autopsy on a recently deceased pig, I noticed something strange. Its decaying skin began to regenerate cells when it accidentally came in contact with aurum. After some further experimentation, I discovered that the aurum will regenerate cells when it comes in contact with an infected specimen. Problem is, the results are only temporary. I'll be reporting these findings to Dr. Hudson. And then if you continue down the hall here, guys, on the left... Yeah, I don't know why I was so buggy while I was recording this, but anyway, on the left here, there's this room with a bunch of spawners in it, and there's this office that should have a document that doesn't work, but I'll read it out for you now. Document CC-03, version 3.1.1. Name, containment cannon. Description, defensive measures against potential containment breaches. Rapid fire. Alright, so here's the rest, the last one after you beat the actual dungeon. It's right above the cure, and it says, letter covered in blood. I do not have much longer in this world. I've been infected by one of the escaped undead. But I must write this down in hopes that someone will find it. I've discovered the cure for the zombie virus. You must brew a nether wart into a glass bottle, and then take that potion and brew it with a fermented spider eye. Find some arum and grind it into a thin powder. Cover any kind of fruit with this powder. Throw the potion and then force feed him the golden fruit. After a few minutes, the zombie will begin to revert back into its human form. This is the cure. Use it to finally put an end to all this. Do not let us all die in vain. Dr. Davies. Alright, so guys, we are here at Riftus, and one of the cool things that Moss showed me is if you stand on this pressure plate here, and you go through here, and he holds a pressure plate open for me, we get a secret little basement in this house, and it opens up to a prison. So you don't want to go in these little places, because as a prison suggests, you can also get a crafting table there, but you can't get out. There's lava, but I don't... There's nothing behind these lava pillars, right?
No. Okay. You could also put items on these pressure pillars.
That's true, if you really wanted to go in and feel like a prisoner. Okay. And, yeah, so this is actually an exit, I hope.
Yeah, with a chest. I think that's a rat. Yeah, that's a rat.
I'll take that. 10 arrows, and then we go back into the cave system, I think.
Yeah, just watch your step.
That's pretty scary.
Yeah. But there you go.
You did not warn me about that.
Free.
Continuing with our underground sort of theme, We are here at Cirrus, and apparently there's something hidden up in that glowstone. So you want to try grappling?
Oh, shoot. Dead.
Oh no, Homash, please. Ah.
Did you die?
No, I haven't even found where to... Okay.
Right at the top. Did you do it?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Alright. So you just gotta fall down. Okay, and then we have a little lore block, but it doesn't say anything, which makes me cry.
It's just a reading room.
But it says, finally a nice play, finally a chance to read in peace. And it has a military epic chest. And yeah, you're just in this glowstone thing. And then obviously you get out. You get
in the water.
In the water. South. In the water. Which way is south? I feel like that's not south. Is this way south? Ugh. Yeah, this way was south. Alright, Mosh, I'm gonna get your Zambi. I don't wanna die to it, so I'm gonna shoot it. Alright, on to the next super cool, awesome thingy-majig.
I'll be back.
Here we are at one of our bonus spots of the video. We are actually at a cave called... What? Mosh? What's it called?
It's the cave entrance.
The cave,
yeah? Yeah, here's...
Alright. So there you go. Can I come in? Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. And the secret meeting place of the infamous Kiss of Death. Ta-da. Ta-da. There's nothing in here. It's kind of just like, yeah, this is where my dungeon group meets all the time.
Yeah.
And we discuss things.
Gate?
Yes.
Yeah, there's a spawner behind each of those.
Okay.
Like a zombie spawner, not
yeah.
Pigman. And what we're going to do is we're going to run to that black tent on the right.
Yeah.
Where I shot that arrow.
Yeah.
And there's a block that you have to stand on while I open up the door via... block glitching.
Please no pigmen. Please no pigmen. Please no pigmen. Please no pigmen. Which block?
Alright, you are going to stand right where I am.
This one right here?
Yep.
Alright.
Alright, let me just pull this zombie.
Zombie coming your way.
Thanks.
You're doing animals for this, right?
I'm not actually.
Oh, okay. You want to just soured?
Mostly geared for Frostbane.
Ah, Frostbane. Are you doing that tomorrow with us?
What?
Or are you gearing for Frostbane for next week? Whoa!
There you go.
Hey, awesome. Alright, that's really cool. Alright, so now I guess I'll try it.
Okay, we should wait for a tip.
That's true. That's very true.
So, you're going to stand on the third block from the wall here.
Yep.
Right here?
Yeah.
And the button is under the block on this side. So you gotta break that block and then right click on it.
Alright, so go stand. Nope.
Yeah, it might take a few tries.
Alright, last.
That's scary.
Oh, no, I'm done.
Alright.
I'm sorry.
All good.
Run.
Did they take out the spawners here?
I don't know. So the Rocksteady should give you resistance 3 and slowness 3 to whoever you shoot or whoever's in the area. Is it like a slowbo?
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm gonna just shoot like right here. Oh, it's gotta hit somebody?
You have to hit them.
And there you go, slowness 3 and resistance 3. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Alright, Strat Abandoned Farm, guys, and one of the cool things is this little pumpkin guy. If you hit him, he says, there's been a strange man with glowing eyes sneaking around here. And, yeah. So I'd be careful around these parts if I were you. And that's just kind of a cool thing you can do at Abandoned Farm. And I guess we're on to the next Easter eggy thing. Ooh, that's a nice chest. Alright, guys, here's another cool secret in the city of Arberton, I want to say. Yeah, Arberton. Where you can get these really cool... Arbreton? Nah, it's Arberton. It's Arberton, bud. Okay, and there's actually a really cool secret basement in this place, and hopefully we'll be able to do it, so let's put the button there. Yeah. And it doesn't do anything. Oh, balls.
Yeah. Woo.
But as you can see, like, there we go.
There's something under that.
There is definitely something. Possible dungeon, maybe? I don't know. And one other cool place, while I look through the redstone here, is that, as this sign says, that you can see in the top left corner, Arberton was built by G1 Fan, XX Saunders, XX, and Olios. So you can find that in the room with the yellow and green carpets. Alright guys, so we're at one of the minor locations that are kind of secret, if you didn't know about them. This one is called the Troll Hole, and we're just at these coordinates, just north of a thing. And he says, gone to lunch, so this is where you gotta pay your toll for the bridge. You get a cool tool chest here, and yeah, I don't think you can access that, no. Those don't do anything, but yeah. Alright, so guys, thank you very much for watching. It took me a very long time to get all those documents, so I want to just say a quick thanks to the dungeon group that I hang out with for doing buys for 2 or 3 times to help me get those documents. I'd like to thank Mosh Von Void for helping me find all those little cool secrets you guys may have saw during the video. And I'd like to thank Mind Reapers and his group for helping me out as well. So guys, I hope you enjoyed learning about some of the secrets of MindZ. I hope that you learned something, and look forward to some new MindZ videos, and maybe some MindZ2 videos. I don't know, MindZ2 is kind of bleh. But for the most part, we're going to keep going with MindZ and see where we go with it. So thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you all next time.